It was a Games full of highs and lows, of triumph and heartbreak. On the final day, the home nation had only won gold in the bowls and badminton. Scotland's hopes were on the girl from Dundee.
My race was last on the track, and you know, people were coming back to the village crying and disappointed, and it was really, really, really hard just to keep the focus. I remember one of the, I think it was Hilda Everett, who was the women's team official, and she came back and she says, "Well, Liz, you know, you're our last chance." And it was just like, I just felt like the weight of the nation on my shoulder, and it's something that I didn't want or envisage. And I just thought, yeah, you know, I'm the last chance of a gold medal here. And yeah, I just remember leaving the room and thinking, I'm going to do it.
But Liz Lynch is in a great position there. I think she's even tempted to take the pace on here somewhere, because she's running strongly. She looks very, very comfortable, and she's going to have to make a move here at some point.
I actually knew from about 1,000 metres out, 2.5 laps to go, that I was going to win it, because I felt really easy. It was kind of like a two-lap victory run, and it was just really amazing, because the stadium was, you just heard the noise, and you know, it just got louder and louder every step you took. So it was a pretty amazing race for me.
Is this the right thing to do? We'll soon know. They've got 800 metres left, and Ordain is not responding. And listen to this crowd.
My dad was a really funny character. He had this thing in his head that he was a jinx if he watched me running. So when I was running the race, he actually left the stadium. He went behind where all the seating was and walked out, because he couldn't watch it. He was so nervous.
And approaching the bell, and possibly approaching goal for Scotland.
Either my mum or an aunt went and shouted to my dad and said, "You need to come and see this, because she's winning it, and she's winning it easily."
As Liz Lynch of Dundee Hawkhill Harriers takes the 10,000 metres goal for Scotland, smashes the British record by an enormous margin.
So he actually did come back in and watch the last sort of couple of laps, which was really amazing for him, because even when he watched races in the house, he would walk out of the room, he wouldn't watch them on the telly. It's really special actually seeing that now, because my dad's no longer with me, and it really brings home just how close and how proud he was. And, you know, he just kept repeating to me all the time, "You've did it, you've did it, my wee lass has done it."
What a great moment for this girl, and what a great moment for the host nation.
When she delivered this gold medal, it salvaged Scottish pride, and it announced a new name. Every Games produces new heroes. So Liz Lynch, Liz McColgan, as she became, was very definitely the big heroine of those Games in 1986.
The Commonwealth Games was the best moment in my running career, simply because I could never relive the emotions of that day. You know, I had a whole stadium packed that was shouting for you. I had my family, my friends, my parents. And I think just the whole emotions of receiving your medal and, you know, winning your race, it was just so immense. And I always thought that when you won, that's how you would feel. Nothing ever lived up to that experience on that day in 1986 in Edinburgh.
Despite a 32-nation boycott, the Games had taken place. Liz McColgan had won gold. Her dream had become a reality.